favorite fortnightly program. The topic for discussion this evening is the upcoming general election. Now, some of you may have been listening to the news that general election may be just around the corner. Depends on how Mr. Boris Johnson plays this Brexit policy and whether they're able to do a Brexit without any deal or what. Obviously, there will be a general election soon. So it's in preparation for the general election that we are going to have this program. Tonight in my studio, we have a number of guests that are involved with the various political parties. I've tried to create a balance by inviting guests from different political parties, but we are struggling in terms of independent supporters. So we've tried to make our program as balanced as possible. The guests, once I introduce you to them, they are known to our community and I'm sure you will know them. If you have any questions for our guests, there will be a telephone number on the screen very soon. You will be able to phone in and participate, talk to our guests directly, and you can ask any questions or you can give us your thoughts on what you think. So, without a further ado, let me introduce you to my first guest, who's sitting on my left. He is Mr. Ruhul Amin. He is a former councillor of London Borough of Tower Hamlets and also a current Labour Black and Minority Ethnic Secretary here in Tower Hamlets. So, Ruhul Amin, a very good evening, sir. Thank you for coming to the show.
Good evening to you, Dursbhai, and thank you for inviting us, and thank you to the whole ATN team.
Thank you very much. Sitting next to Ruhul Amin is Afzal Saeed Munna, who is a political activist. Good evening, Munna Bhai, and thank you very much for coming along.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me. Good evening, viewers.
Thank you. Thank you. Sitting on my right is Momshed Afruz, who is involved with the Conservative Party. He has stood as a Conservative candidate in Tower Hamlets previously and is actively campaigning for the Conservative Party. So, Momshed, a very good evening and thank you for coming to the show.
Thank you very much for extending an invite, Dursbhai, and it's an absolute pleasure to be in your program.
Thank you very much. And sitting next to Momshed Afruz is Josh Babarinde. Have I got that right?
Oh, yes, you have. Yeah.
Josh, very good evening to you. I know you're involved with the Liberal Party. You're a campaigner for the Liberal Party. Thank you for making the time to come to my program. Thank you. Right. My first question is to Mr. Ruhul Amin. In your opinion, how likely is it that we will have a general election in the near future? And is it right and proper that we should be having a general election now?
Thank you for the question, Dursbhai. It is very likely, to put it simply, that we will have an election because, as we know, the Prime Minister wanted to have election immediately. But our party and other opposition parties did not want to have an election immediately, purely because they wanted the Prime Minister to actually go back to the EU to get a deal and then go for the election. So I believe that we will have an election very soon. And obviously, the Parliament has passed a bill where you know, he has to sort of get a deal for the UK, or else it will be unlawful. And we can't actually afford to have another unlawful act from a disastrous Prime Minister. We've seen this with the recent High Court, the Supreme Court ruling, where this was unprecedented, never in the history of this country we saw a Prime Minister who was found doing something unlawful. He even actually lied to the Queen, by the looks of it, because if the judges actually think that that was wrong, then we have to respect the judgment. Right. And I believe that it is only a matter of time. We will have election, but obviously our party and most of the opposition, they want a election after the Prime Minister has done a deal with the EU.
Right. So, in your opinion, then, that we will have a general election, but this will be dependent on the outcome of the Brexit, whether we have a deal or a no deal. You said that there was a bill that was passed which said that they have to complete this Brexit, is that correct?
That's right, yes.
Okay, let me put that to the Conservative party member stroke campaigner, to Momshed Afruz. You've heard what Ruhul Amin have just said. It's the first time that a Prime Minister has been proved of misleading the monarch by suspending the parliament, and it wasn't until that the High Court had given a ruling that it was unlawful mm-hmm. that they've decided to reinstate the parliament mm-hmm. so that it can continue.
Sure.
Do you think this is not embarrassing for a Prime Minister like Mr. Boris Johnson, and also misleading the monarch as well as the general public?
We've got to wind the clock back. So the act of prorogation is permissible under our constitution. Prorogation means resetting of the parliamentary term. So the term that we had running for 2 years, it's been the longest for the last 200 years. So when the government wants to reset its program, it presses the reset button. That means parliament goes into prorogation for a couple of weeks, and then a new session starts where the Queen outlines through her speech the government's legislative program. In this instance, what the Prime Minister did, he prorogated the parliament for a couple of weeks. Now, that is, of course, when you compare it with some of the length of time that's been prorogued, historically, it's been somewhat a longer period. So Gina Miller, I think, who took that matter to High Court and then to Supreme Court, the highest court of the land, and their verdict was the actual duration of the prorogation was perhaps a lot longer than it needed to be. And in their view, they felt perhaps the Prime Minister was trying to use the act of prorogation to circumvent Parliament.
I think it's quite clear that the Prime Minister was trying to use the prorogation to his advantage so that the House of Parliament did not have the opportunity to discuss this Brexit issue fully.
Well, absolutely not. I think House of Parliament had, more than 2 years to debate Brexit, and they done the whole Brexit to death, right? What the Labour Party and the Liberal Democrats have done over the last 2 years and more, they have tried to tie the hands of not just Theresa May, but also with Mr. Johnson, by forcing our government to actually enact the Benz Act, which forces the government to actually seek an extension with the European Union. Now, if you're going into any kind of negotiation in any form, and if your counterparty knows that no matter what is the outcome of that negotiation, you are not able to walk away from it, then they have the upper hand. And this is exactly what Labour has done. They forced the Prime Minister's hand through the Benz Act, where he is now required by law to actually go and seek extension. Now, we already had an extension, and it serves absolutely no purpose. So what has the Parliament been doing for the last 2 years? You know, we had many votes on different permutations of Brexit, and we haven't managed to come up with any kind of concrete proposition as to how we want to achieve Brexit. Our position is very clear. We want to have a Brexit with a deal. And this has been the government's position from day one.
He has not moved
from that position.
If I can just interject, according to the Conservative conference, I understand, a decision has been made that whether we have a deal or a no deal, we will be out of Europe by the 31st of October. Surely a decision of that magnitude needs to be thoroughly debated. And whatever the outcome is, it has to be one that will benefit the country. It seems like that the Tories are trying to push it through purely to fulfill their own egos.
For
the benefit of the country.
Can I just come back to that? I think it's very, very important. When we had the referendum, it was a binary choice. Do you want to remain in the European Union or do you want to leave the European Union?
Yeah.
It didn't then say, turn over page two. Do you want a soft Brexit? Do you want a hard Brexit? Do you want a Brexit with customs union? Do you want a Brexit with single market? It didn't say any of those
things.
17.5 million
allow me
people.
Allow me to put this question to you. The people were misled.
No, that
is. Campaigners who wanted to leave Europe, they were given false information.
That is a subjective opinion.
Because of that, a lot of young people voted to leave the Europe and didn't know exactly what they
meant. Doesn't stack up.
Can I just quickly come in?
Sure.
I have to say that, look, end of the day, it was your party actually decided to go for the referendum. It was your party.
And for good reasons.
Who your previous Prime Minister, Theresa May, she actually mentioned that because of the many erratic decisions of your party, she herself actually referred to your party as the nasty party. Look, I grew up in the 80s, okay? And I saw how the Conservative Party literally decimated all public services. I grew up in the 80s and 90s. I saw
and Conservative Party decimated
this same party could come into
public
power
services.
History is repeating itself. Okay? We are seeing every single sector.
Let the Liberal, I have to finish this, just allow me 30 seconds.
Okay, right. We are seeing the worst government in the history of Britain. We are seeing the worst Prime Minister. I can bet you my last pound, this man, Boris Johnson, won't last very long, trust me.
Let me bring the Liberal person in.
Nearly 30 of his MPs has left the party. I don't see any future for this party to govern.
Thank you.
Let the
Liberal man come in. Josh?
I've patiently sat and listened to your arguments, and thank you very much. I'm going to come back to some of the questions that you asked, if you don't mind.
What are your thoughts on this?
So the first question is, will there be a general election soon? Absolutely yes, is my answer. Boris Johnson's government does not have a majority. In fact, it's got a majority of minus 43. Yeah. This means that alone it cannot get anything through Parliament. Right. And very unfortunately, last week, Boris Johnson resorted to some really terrible tactics in Parliament that have totally kind of
He's
destroyed.
Trying every trick in the book,
He's
isn't he?
He's trying every trick in the book,
yeah.
And no one trusts him. He's not going to be able to form any kind of majority for any kind of policy he wants to pass. So Parliament will be stuck. That's why we need an election soon.
Right.
And that's why it's going to happen soon. Number two, there was a question on the prorogation of Parliament.
Of Parliament, yes.
And my Conservative colleague referred to the Supreme Court saying that perhaps they inferred that Boris Johnson overstepped the mark. I'm afraid there was no perhaps about it.
Yes.
It is very clear in the judgment from the Supreme Court that the prorogation was illegal.
Unlawful.
The advice that was provided to the Queen was illegal.
Yeah.
The Prime Minister,
which had put the Queen, the monarch, in a very embarrassing position.
Extremely embarrassing. And Boris Johnson should publicly apologise for misleading the Queen. No one on record has done this in the history of our country, or not since the 1700s or whatever. Sure. So I'm afraid that the line that only a small overstepping of the mark has happened is an extreme understatement. The highest court in the land said that our Prime Minister acted illegally, and Boris Johnson should resign as a result. Now, my third point, there was another question.
Very quickly, because I need to go to the other person. Go on.
There was another question that my colleague answered on Brexit and the lies during the original campaign in 2016.
That's right.
I'm afraid that there were facts that were outlined as facts that indeed were not facts at all.
Right.
The £350 million
that Nigel Farage said.
Not just Nigel Farage, but our present Prime Minister.
Yeah, that would be put into the NHS.
A week for the NHS.
Yeah.
That's not happening.
Yeah.
Turkey is able to join the European Union, is what they were saying. That isn't happening. We would have to give permission for that to happen. There were so many lies that were told during that campaign, and I'm afraid many people were misled. And in fact,
we're branding this as a Conservative campaign. It wasn't.
That
it was a cross-party campaign.
Hang on, that campaign overspent.
Maybe.
It broke the campaign
rules.
We'll
talk about the campaign. We'll talk about the spending. I'll come back to you. Let this gentleman come in. Did the Prime Minister act unlawfully in terms of suspending the Parliament?
Thank you, David. I think my Lib Dem colleague already mentioned about that. But
yeah.
I would go back a little bit back where you have answered the asked the questions.
We've got
about
2 minutes before
will there be
to go on
any general election?
Yeah.
And the answer is yes, there will be a general election. Because why we need a general election? We need a general election is because we need to sort out the Brexit mess, number one. And if you looked into your particular questions answered about that, whether the Prime Minister's decisions was unlawful or not. Now, the thing is, prorogation decisions that came from the Supreme Court was not about Brexit, was not about anything else. It was purely based on the duration. So whether we can suspend the Parliament on that particular 6 weeks durations or not. Now the question is was unlawful.
Which wouldn't have given the
that
MPs
was
the opportunity
yes.
to discuss Brexit fully.
Exactly. Yeah. And obviously Prime Minister Boris Johnson, who is very much sure to deliver the Brexit on 31st of October, he never going to say the true pictures to the Queen's as well. And obviously, Queen doesn't require to know all these things in details because he has given the power to these gentlemen to form the government. Now, if you looked into Conservative Party's their conferences, right? The conference motive is deliver the Brexit. Yeah. Now, the question is, you have pre-planned this conference. It was not something that you just came from US, from this climate issue conferences, and you suddenly decided to have a conference. Your conference was dealt many months ago, so you know that you're going to deliver.
Yeah?
It was a pre-planned.
Yeah, pre-planned.
And if you looked into that, you suspended the Parliament up to the Queen's speech, which is going to happen on 14th of October, and then 17th of October, you're going to Brussels to attend these EU conferences. Literally, you're not leaving any spaces for anyone to run the general elections because you need to at least allow 25 days of polling days to call the elections. So you're basically, you pre-planned and well-prepared, decisions that you try to do that. Now, there are many things.
Thank you. We need to go on a break. If we don't go on a break on time, we won't be able to continue.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please don't go anywhere. Stay with us. We're going to go on a short break. We'll be back very soon. Thank you.
Shoujonne, General Auto Services.
JMG Cargo এখন আরো গতিশীল বাংলাদেশ বিমান সহ ইত্তেহাদ ও সৌদি এয়ারলাইন্সেও আপনার মূল্যবান মালামাল পৌঁছে যাবে দ্রুততম সময়ে আর এজন্য আপনি পাচ্ছেন বিশেষ ডিসকাউন্টে মালামাল পাঠানোর সুযোগ JMG Cargo আস্থা ও বিশ্বস্ততার প্রতীক
ডিজাইনের সব সময় যাদের থাকে আধুনিকতার ছোঁয়া ম্যাটেরিয়াল যাদের সব সময় উন্নত কোয়ালিটিতে যারা আপোষ করে না মডার্ন কার্পেটস এন্ড ফার্নিচার নিজেরাই ইম্পোর্ট করে তাই মডার্নের আছে হিউজ স্টক ফলে মডার্ন দিতে পারে কুইক ডেলিভারি আপনার পছন্দের যাবতীয় ফার্নিচার কার্পেট বা ফ্লোরিং এর মেজারমেন্ট এবং ফিটিং একেবারে ফ্রি ভিজিট করুন মডার্ন কার্পেটস এন্ড ফার্নিচার 92-94 রোমান রোড ব্যাথল গ্রিন লন্ডন
ইস্ট লন্ডনের জনপ্রিয় হালাল ডেজার্ট রেস্টুরেন্ট লাভচক নিয়ে এলো হরেক রকম স্বাদের মজাদার খাবার, কোকিডো, ওয়াফল, আইসক্রিম, মিল্কশেক, মকটেলস এবং নানা ধরনের কেক সহ বাহারি ও রুচিসম্মত খাবারের এক বিশ্বস্ত প্রতিষ্ঠান লাভচক। লাভচক 112 বার্কিং রোড, কেনিংটাউন, লন্ডন, E16 1EN, ফোন 0208 616 8808.
Getting married? Congratulations! The Ariana Banqueting Hall is setting stunning landscape gardens surrounded by green hills and ancient trees. 800 seating capacity. The Ariana Banqueting Hall, Oakley Road South, Brunswick Park Road, London.
Cannon Street-er quality food bordhito akare, notun rupe, notun shaje. Tai London o ashepasher kretader prothom pochondo quality food. Karon
quality food er royeche quality vegetable.
Karon ta ektai, amar chai shera jinish. Our quality foods IPCO brand e shera jinish tei rakhe.
আপনার
চাহিদা এবং আমাদের উন্নত সেবা, তাই আপনার পছন্দের প্রিয় দোকান কোয়ালিটি ফুড, 125-127 ক্যানন স্ট্রিট রোড, লন্ডন E1, ফোন 0207480-7460.
Whenever you have something really cold or really hot and then you get this short, sharp kind of sensation through your teeth, it kind of goes straight in and stimulates those nerves, and that's that sensitivity. It can get worse. The problem is not going to go away by itself. You need to do something about it. I always recommend Sensodyne. It blocks that uncomfortable sensation and calms the nerve down. And I've had people coming back to me saying it's made a difference. It works.
New Sensodyne Extra Fresh. Daily care for sensitive teeth with an instant fresh breath feeling.
I just threw it together. This?
It looks so much better on you.
Red's not my colour.
Really?
I like you.
You must be joking.
You like me too.
What are you after?
I like you.
When we throw out the old workwear rules, we can't be told to wear a power suit to be empowered. We all like sharp lines sometimes, but what we like even more is the line, "This look is a bit of me, it's mine." It's all about what we need to put on, to push on, to break barriers down, to be a mother, a boss, every single one of us going above and beyond to fill our lives with what we love to work in. So go on, put it on.
KFC, Wagamama, Greek salad, no carbs before Marv's there, Karen. Pizza Express, Dave. Here's your Burger King, Dad. There we are. Bad guys, lads. And Coma, during as ever, Dino.
Oh, buongiorno italiano. Oh, prawn crackers.
All your family favourites, now on Deliveroo.
Who ordered wings?
Amazon has low prices on millions of items. Welcome, snugglers. Welcome, everyone.
Having a workplace pension is like having another you. At work, helping earn money for when you retire. Get to know your pension. Visit workplacepensions.gov.uk.
It's a new day at Antan Deck, and the team are talking mortgages.
What are houses made of?
Mortgages?
No, bricks. And bricks must be well cheap.
They're based.
সৌজন্যে জেনারেল অটো সার্ভিসেস।
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back from our break. Thank you for staying with us. On the other end, if you have just joined us, a very big welcome. The topic for discussion this evening is the upcoming general election. And just before we went on break, I was talking to our guest about the suspension of the parliament, whether it was lawful or unlawful. And I know that from the Supreme Court's ruling, it was deemed to be unlawful. The parliament is back again in action, and we hope that they will be in a position to debate this very critical issue about Brexit, and they'll, whatever the decision that they make, will be one that will be anonymous and one that will be beneficial to Great Britain's future. Just before we went on break, I was talking to Afzal Saeed Munna, and you were trying to make your final point. Do you want to do that now?
Yeah, please. Thank you very much for giving me that opportunity. Yes, I was trying to say that how the provocations actually happened from the beginning. So I was watching Sajid Javid's speech today for the Conservative Conference, and I was wondering that seeing that message, the massive message they're delivering, that they deliver the Brexit. So that means it's pre-planned. So if we looked into the durations, like why he, our Prime Ministers wanted to have a 5 to 6 weeks of suspensions on the parliaments, and Queen's speech on 14th, 17th, he's going to join Brussels for the EU conferences, and 31st of October deliver the no deal Brexit. Now, this is a pre-planned timeline that we not going to get any opportunity to have heavy-handed questions and
so
deliver that to the Boris.
Let me put this to you. Had it not been for the Supreme Court's ruling, the parliament wouldn't have had the opportunity to discuss this had this suspension went along with what Mr. Johnson did. Is that correct?
Well, the parliament, what I was trying to say from the beginning as well, the Supreme Court didn't say, made the decisions whether it is unlawful or lawful based on any other distinctions. Supreme Court's decision was purely based on the duration.
On the time.
On the duration.
Right,
so if Boris Johnson went for 2 weeks, there was no issue.
We have a caller. Let's just take the call and we will continue.
Thank you.
Hello, caller. Good evening. Assalamu alaikum.
হ্যালো আসসালামু আলাইকুম ভাই সাহেব।
আসসালামু আলাইকুম জি ভাইয়া। হুজ কলিং
ভাই সাহেব, আমি বার্মিংহাম থেকে সুমন ভাই আর
জি ই কল ফ্রম বার্মিংহাম। আপনার নামটা কি হইলো?
প্রথম আপনারে অভিনন্দন জানাই আর
জি,
আর এখানে যারা আইফোন স্টুডিও সবাইরে আমি আন্তরিক অভিনন্দন জানাই আর।
থ্যাংক ইউ ভাই। আপনার নামটা কইবানি?
আমার নাম সুমন ভাই আর বার্মিংহাম থেকে।
সুমন, ওকে ভাই। এখন কোশ্চেন আপনার প্রশ্নটা কি?
কংগ্রাচুলেশন সবরে, আর আন্তরিকভাবে সবাইরে আমি অভিনন্দন জানাই আর, এবং রুহুল আমিন ভাইরে
জি,
বিশেষ করে রুহুল আমিন বাইরে আর আপনারা যারা আছেন সবে। সবচেয়ে বড় কথা হইল যে রুহুল আমিন বাইর মতো মানুষ আর আপনারা যারা এখানে আছেন, আপনারা থাকার কারণে আজকে আমরা বাঙালি কমিউনিটি অনেক উপকার আর ইনশাআল্লাহ ভবিষ্যতে যেন আপনারা আল্লাহ থাকবা আমরা বাঙালি কমিউনিটির জন্য। আর সবাই ধন্যবাদ জানাই আর, বিশেষ করে রুহুল আমিন বাইরে ধন্যবাদ জানাই আর, দরসুল্লাহ ভাই আপনারাও ধন্যবাদ জানাই আর।
থ্যাংক ইউ, থ্যাংক ইউ ভাই। আপনি বানুয়াম থেকে কল করার লাগি, রুহুল আমিন ভাই আপনার সব কথাগুলো শুনছেন। রুহুল আমিন ভাই, ওয়ান অফ ইউর
ধন্যবাদ
সাপোর্টার,
কল করার লাগি। থ্যাংক ইউ।
Okay, Shumun bhai, thank you. Right, so we will go back to Munna bhai to conclude what you were saying.
Yeah, I mean that was the main decisions, that the decision was on the durations. So if Boris Johnson went for 2 weeks, there was no issues that Gina Miller will step in.
But as it was just a duration.
Yeah, it's just the duration.
Okay, now you've mentioned at the beginning that what Sajid Javed had said. I think one of the question that was put to him at the conference was about the recent headlines concerning Mr. Boris Johnson and a model or an entrepreneur, a business entrepreneur from America, about their relationship. And he did not want to comment about someone's personal relationship. But don't you think, where it involves the Prime Minister, that the public have the right to know exactly what their relationship is and the grant that was made to this individual when Boris Johnson was the mayor of London?
The thing is that it's pretty personal for him. Where he do not wanted to make a comment about it, I think I should not make a comment about his personal life as well, that whom he is going to be with, who is going to be his friends or so on. Okay. So far I know she is a very good friend of him. And obviously, you know, when you are in a power, when you have the capacity to help somebody in various ways, you will be doing that. So probably that could be one of the gesture from him as a friend, Boris, not as a as somebody else. That is my understanding. But to be very fair with you, if that it deals with that funding that comes from the taxpayers' money in the United Kingdom, then definitely Boris Johnson has to be put under.
He should be held accountable.
And then held accountable.
Sure.
At least we as a citizen should know that where from this money came and why it was given
to her. Right. Okay, fair enough. Let me put this question perhaps to Ruhul Amin Bhai. At this conference, Sajid Javed also made a number of promises, and in particular he wants to give billions for the roads and the infrastructure, promises that he is making. Do you think that the Tories will win the next general election and will be able to deliver the promises that are being made, especially in terms of the amount of money that are being promised? Where is it going to all come from?
25 billion, by the way.
Thank you for the question, Doroswai. Personally, I think, obviously, knowing the Tories and what they've done previously, since they've been in power from 2010, they've never really kept their promises. I honestly believe that they will not actually invest that money. Look at the police numbers. They took away something like 200,000 police.
Sure, but do you think they'll be able to deliver or not?
I don't think so.
Thank you. Let me go to Josh. Yeah. Josh, what is your opinion on this? Do you think they'd be able to deliver? Or is it just empty promises that they're making, which if they win the general election, they'll say, we are not in power. And whoever gets in, they'll probably make them bankrupt anyway, because they won't have the money to be able to deliver. What do you think?
Well, several things. Number one, I don't think we can trust a word that Boris Johnson says, right?
Well, it wasn't Boris Johnson, it was Sajid Javed who had said this.
Boris Johnson's
and his government.
Sajid Javed serves. And I'll tell you why. Time after time, we've had lie after lie from Boris Johnson and his colleagues, whether it was during the referendum campaign with all this 350 million on the bus, whether it is in his decision to prorogue Parliament. It's been proved that he can lie to the Queen. Yeah. If he's going to lie to the Queen, then...
So, in your opinion, he's a liar and he cannot be trusted?
I don't think that we can trust what he says.
Thank you.
I want to come to the question on Boris Johnson's private life.
I will let you... All right, go on, very quickly, make that. Go on.
I don't think that politicians' private lives should be all over the newspapers necessarily.
Right.
I don't think that's appropriate.
But if they're a public figure, they have to behave themselves in a rational manner. That is the minimum expectation.
Well, let's talk about this very specific case briefly.
Okay.
Boris Johnson declared some time ago that he had no interest to declare in the awarding of this grant to the lady in question.
Right.
If, though, it has transpired that there was some kind of relationship that was taking place between them, clearly Boris Johnson has more than just no interest.
It's in the public knowledge today that the lady in question had told her friends that she was having a sexual relationship with the Prime Minister, and those people are talking to the press. That's what I read this morning in the Daily Mail.
But my point is, if it were the case that such a relationship were to be taking place at the same time as the lady in question received a grant from Boris Johnson, then of course it's in the public interest to investigate this.
Thank you. Boris Johnson cannot be trusted.
This is classic character assassination.
Okay.
When they realize that the man is riding high in public opinion, and this is backed up by various polls that's
misleading
been
the Queen
taking place. Now, on the question of misleading the Queen and prorogation, as you know, Doris Bhai, we in this country do not have a written constitution.
No, so
the rules are not written in black and white. With the act of prorogation, the Prime Minister wanted to test the remit of the law.
You don't test the law by breaking the law.
Let me just articulate. I think it's absolutely important. Because there was no clear guidance forthcoming, the Prime Minister decided to test the boundary of the law.
He decided to break.
And on the advice of the Attorney General, who is the government's legal advisor,
a politician,
he went to prorogate Parliament. Now, of course, Jeffrey Cox, the Attorney General.
Yeah, okay.
So obviously, on his advice, he prorogued Parliament, and we know the whole story, which had unfolded afterwards.
Hang on, gentlemen. There is a caller on the line. Let's just take the call. Hello, caller. Good evening. Assalamu alaikum.
Can you translate for me?
Hello, caller.
Sure, I'll try.
Hello, caller. Right, seems like there's a technical problem. Call up, please do call back again, and we will take your call. Thank you. Sorry.
As I was saying, we have various checks and balances in place. The judiciary is independent of the legislative. The legislative is independent of the executive. And those checks and balances came into force, and the Supreme Court ruled that the duration of the prorogation was not fit for purpose, right? So I don't think the Prime Minister went in with the intention to actually use prorogation as a way of circumventing Parliament.
There was a loophole which the Prime Minister wanted to use that.
That is something been sort of peddled into the public domain by.
As Prime Minister, was not advised by an LCP. He was advised by an Attorney General who is practicing law and plus a politician. He knew what is lawful and what is unlawful. He knew his colleagues
We don't have a written constitution. The Constitution doesn't say.
And also going to the Queen.
You have to prorogue Parliament by 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
Yeah, but
there was no set time limit, it is open-ended
and
prorogue the Parliament for
open
X amount of time
interpretation. And the Prime Minister decided to take a view, which was of course.
You want to come in, Ruhul Bhai?
Yeah, right. I just wanted to ask Munshad Bhai, never in the history of British policy we had a such long prorogation, you see. So naturally people wonder, why is he doing this?
Can I come back to this?
One at a time.
Taking place in the Parliament.
Go on.
I think it's a perfectly valid question. We never in this country or in this country's history had a political party in opposition which is at complete odds with the electorate. 17.5 million people voted to take this country out of the European. What is your leader's position? The position is we want to remain in the European Union with inside the single market. We want to remain in the European Union with customs union. That is not Brexit. That is not Brexit at all.
You haven't made it clear.
Your Member of Parliament,
gentlemen, one at a time. Go on.
If you just give me literally 30 seconds, I want to make another point.
Yeah, go on. Just make
your Member of Parliament and the constituencies they represent, they are by and large Leave constituencies. Your Labour Member of Parliament, by and large, they're Remainers. You are at odds with the electorate. You're pitting Parliament against the electorate. You are going to lose this general election with this party leader who, for all intents and purposes, needs to go back to where he came from, and that is his allotment.
The point you want to make in relation to 17.5 million voters have voted to leave Europe. Now, if they were to go back, what does that say about democracy?
This is what I believe. My party, which is the Labour Party, we were for Remain during the referendum. But after the referendum, when Leave campaign won, we respected that decision and we sort of went along. And that was that is still our position, that we will respect that decision. But recently Jeremy Corbyn has actually announced that if Labour holds the next government, which is very likely because of the many...
So the poll doesn't suggest that. You are on 28%.
And we're on 41. If Jeremy Corbyn wins the next election, gentlemen, will there be a second referendum?
Yes, our leader...
That is the position of the deputy leader.
If there is a second referendum, and that says, again, leave Europe, are we going to go through the same process again?
This is what Labour wants.
Basically, the Labour position is this way, is that if Labour becomes the government, then we will actually have a referendum on the deal, basically.
Thank you. Let me ask the Liberal man. What is your stance on this? Because obviously Liberals are probably scoring the brownie points in terms of Europe. And a lot of the people, both from the Tory Party...
Yeah, they have become the safe haven for the rejects.
Well, they've joined the Liberal Party.
Well, with greatest respect, the deal that you have attempted to put through Parliament has been rejected 3 times. I think the rejects are elsewhere. But the Conservative position is to leave the European Union come what may, deal or no deal, and it's looking more likely it'll be the latter.
No deal.
I'm afraid the Labour position is absolutely... unbelievable. The Labour Party voted last week to have a neutral position on remaining or leaving in the European Union at the next election. This is one of the biggest issues of our time, and they're on the fence. Now, the Liberal Democrats, what we believe is that if we are elected to form a majority government after the next election, that will send a message to people that they've thought again and they want to stay in the European Union. And in that regard, we would revoke Article 50 and remain in the European
Union.
That is
not your position. Your position is to revoke Article 50 regardless.
Yes.
That is the motion that's been adopted. It's very crystal clear.
It's not.
Either you have trouble reading.
Yeah, this is your policy.
And no, it's not. If we form a majority government after the next election,
I think you're missing one
at a time.
Issues are very clear.
If the party becomes
what does it mean?
If we win majority government, we will revoke Article 50.
And let me just answer that question because you asked me why the party. My party is on the fence. We are not on the fence. We respect democracy. Okay? But that is why our party decided to respect the referendum. We didn't actually go out there and make a hoo-ha about it, basically. Yeah? We respect it. We wanted to move on. And that is why we think that we will actually wait and see.
Why has it taken you so long to call for a second referendum?
You're just talking about deals now.
We are in a position, we haven't lied to the public like you guys have in the past. We know, under Nikhil's leadership. Look what
happened. Don't talk about the tissue things again.
You went into a coalition with the Tories, the Nazi party, and look what happened. Your party got decimated in 2015. Okay? You backtracked on the very policy that you actually won many seats on, which was the free tuition. Okay.
That was Labour policy, Ruhul, but just to remind you.
And many others. So Lib Dems cannot be trusted, basically. Lib Dems have become the party of the Lib Dems, basically.
Well, Lib Dems is the party that has to be trusted now with the many Lib Dems.
You see, some people leaving the Labour Party join the Lib.
Well, let me put this to you. Hang on, gentlemen, hang on.
I need to address the criticism.
The general consensus out there is that the Tories cannot be trusted.
Well, I beg to differ. That's not a general concern.
The Liberal cannot be trusted. The leader of the Labour Party is not fit to form a government.
So who is going to run this country?
I'm afraid I've just had a number of criticisms levelled against me.
Okay.
I need the opportunity.
All right, all right. Okay.
Okay.
Go on. Respond to them very quickly. We've only got about 2 minutes left.
No problem.
Okay.
We can reflect on the past, and the Liberal Democrats accept that some mistakes were made in government before.
Go on.
Make your point because we need to go on a break. Yeah.
But we are not a party that led our country into an illegal war some years ago. One of the most disastrous decisions that were ever made.
So
you cannot sit there on some kind of moral high horse and start dictating to people who made mistakes before and who hadn't. Now, in terms of the democracy point, we have elections so that people can vote for a party whose policies they can see enacted in government. What we are saying is we will give the British public a second chance to stay in the European Union. And if we form a majority government, if that number of people vote for us in the next election, it is only right that we act on what our manifesto promise said to revoke Article 50 on day one. If
we will talk about your party's manifesto.
So essentially, you just want to renegade on the outcome of the referendum. That's what your position is.
I personally, I think, you know, the electorate has lost the trust and the confidence in your party, honestly. But look how many leaders you guys have had in the last 2 years. That says a lot, doesn't it? Okay. Look, I've got 10 most policies you guys have backtracked on. Tuition fees, VAT, tax cut for millionaires, living standards, NHS, mansion tax, constitutional reform.
Right. We need to very quickly
sure
finish
start,
off.
Yeah. Which was
we need to go on a break. Finish off your list.
Yeah, sure start.
Yeah.
The police numbers, which you supported the Conservatives to cut, and special advisors. We, apart from the Iraq war, I do agree that, you know,
thank you, thank you, Rulbai. We need to go on a break. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to go on a short break. After the break, we will continue, gentlemen. We will continue after the break. Thank you.
From the Iraq war, it's humongous.
General Auto Services.
There is only one store you can trust to build the home of your dreams, whether it is the living room or the bedroom. Marble Furnishing has it all. Quality, wide range of choice and value for money. Let us make you feel at home with Marble Furnishing. Marble Furnishing, 2329 Dodd Street, London, E14 7ET. Call 020-7515-0101.
বড় স্বাদের আপনি বিরিয়ানি বিক্রি চালু হয়েছে অত স্বাদের আপনি বিরিয়ানি লন্ডনের কোন জায়গা পাইতে না
দাম মাত্র 3.5 pounds
তারা তো খালি শুক্রবারে আপনি বেচন
তারা এখন থাকি সপ্তাহে 7 days আপনি বেচন
সপ্তাহে 7 days তোলো হোক কলে যাই টিফিন
টিফিন 165 ক্যানন স্ট্রিট রোড লন্ডন E1 2LX
Getting into debt is easy. Getting out of debt is the hard part. If you're struggling to meet your repayments, call NDC to find out how you could become debt-free with an IVA. Providing you qualify, your monthly repayments will be reduced by hundreds of pounds and up to 75% off your debt will be written off, setting you completely debt-free. Call NDC on 0800 121 4733.
ভালো কথা দেশে কি টাকাটা পাঠিয়েছো
দুইটা দারুণ হয়েছে আর একটু দাও তো হ্যাঁ টাকা তো পাঠিয়ে দিয়েছি
মাত্র পাঠালে
এখানে বসে দেশে টাকা পাঠালে কিভাবে
বাবা দেশে টাকা পাঠানো এখন আরো সিম্পল সিম্পল ট্রান্সফারের রেজিস্ট্রেশন করে যে কোনো সময়ে যে কোনো জায়গায় বসে দেশে টাকা পাঠাতে পারেন এক নিমিশে
নে ধর আমারটা এখনই রেজিস্ট্রেশন কর
সিম্পল ট্রান্সফার দেশে টাকা পাঠানো এখন আরো সিম্পল এ প্রোডাক্ট অফ সিম্পল কল
বারাকা মানি ট্রান্সফারের সৌজন্যে আজকের টাকা রেট ম্যানর পার্ক এবং হোয়াইট চ্যাপেল শাখায় রবিবার সহ প্রতিদিন রাত 8টা পর্যন্ত ইনস্ট্যান্ট ক্যাশ সার্ভিস টেলিফোন 0207-247-0800
You won't let the tree defeat you. You've got exploring to do. It's time to gather your strength. So mix, swirl, twirl. And keep climbing, fearless tree conqueror. Arla Explorer Swirl, yogurt for adventurous kids.
There are two ways to start your day. Choose 4 layers of fortified whole grain shreddiness, or not. Life happens. Shreddy or not.
The new Eau de Parfum. Yves Saint Laurent.
Hello.
The Home Event. 20% off home. Now on at John Lewis and Partners.
Are your energy bills running wild? Let us take you and your bills from
to Money Supermarket's energy monitor tames your bills so you'll never have to overpay again. Get energy monitor. Get money car. Money Supermarket.
With our Tap and Track app, you can follow your AA mechanic all the way to your side. Switch to a different kind of breakdown service for just £4.50 a month. Visit theaa.com.
This is Peloton.
Let's get this started.
Studio cycling, live and on demand in your home. This is thousands of riders connecting with world-class instructors and each other. This is a game-changing workout.
If I'm correct, I remember you said to my colleagues that you worked in the financial sector, which I respect as well, but you cannot ignore the people, those who are working in the financial sector.
You're saying the promises that he made won't be actually costing the government a penny, but it will come out of
exactly and to be honest, industries. And to be honest, Dorisbhai, in his conferences, he was crucified by the media by saying that, do you have a clear idea what exactly is going to cost to deliver the Brexit? And as an exchequer, he hasn't got the idea of amount, and he is going to deliver what he is promising.
Thank you. Thank you. Because Momshad indicated right, as an exchequer, he doesn't have an idea. Do you agree with that?
It's absolutely preposterous. The reason why that is absolutely preposterous, because we have a Department of Brexit, right? We also have issued policy papers, particularly focusing on different sectors and what the potential impact could be and what are the provisions and safeguards that we need to put in place to weather the storm, and they have been fully costed. Initially, we have earmarked 2.5 billion and there are new funding coming along to make sure that
make
we are prepared
quickly,
for
because
Brexit.
I've only got 2 minutes left. Go on.
Brexit. The other thing I want to know,
in terms of your Brexit preparations, you know what you are doing. You even don't know how much it's going to cost but you're actually spending £100 million.
Thank you.
You
have to extend me the courtesy because I didn't interject when you were making a point.
Make your point very quickly because we are running out of time.
What Ruhul Bhai said about when he was reading out this long list of Labour policies, one policy area I want to lift up is the fact that Jeremy Corbyn has now committed to abolishing free market on the NHS. What he wants to do is actually create a company that manufactures drugs. In other words, he wants to do away with the free market. Free market is one of the cornerstones of a free democracy. He wants to roll back the time, take us back to winter of discontent when unemployment was high, inflation was high, this country's finance was, you know, teetering on the brink, and this is the kind
of politics. So you're saying that the Labour policies will go back to that?
The Labour politics is the politics of the 1970s.
Ruhul Bhai, do you want to quickly address this? I don't have much time. Very quickly.
Labour politics, when we were in power from 1997 to 2010, okay? Most of the pledges we made, we managed to sort of deliver. Okay.
In terms of this issue you just mentioned.
Very quickly, 30 seconds, because I have to finish.
We all the policies or pledges that we are making for the future are public friendly, country friendly. So naturally, any government would
want
to do things.
And it needs to be costed. Thank you very much, gentlemen. I'm sorry, Josh, I couldn't come back to you.
Wow. But no deal, no idea.
No ideas, right. Okay, you've all made your points.
No trust,
Thank you all for coming along to my show. No doubt we will have more programs on this subject, and I will invite all of you to come back again to continue with this debate.
In
the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching the program. Please keep well, keep safe, until we see you again. Assalamu alaikum, good night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.